Hi everyone, this video is about regulation of respiration. We know that respiration is a reflex process. That is, in most of the cases, respiration happens involuntarily. That is, we need not think about respiration all the time, when to start or when to stop. Okay, but in some cases, respiration, we can see it as purely as a voluntary process. Okay, for example, if a person need to hold his breath for some time, you might have seen people holding their breath to 1 minute or even beyond that, right? So in such cases, we can see this respiration is as a voluntary action, okay? And in others cases, in other examples, we can see if the person is having any outburst of emotions or if the person is exercising, you can find the rate of respiration is increased, is high. Okay, so depending on each physiological condition, the rate and depth of respiration can vary. Okay, so from this we can understand that respiration, like all the process inside the body, is also controlled by a certain mechanism. Okay, so the depth of inspiration or expiration, depending on certain physiological condition, how it can be controlled. Okay, it is controlled by certain regulatory mechanism in body, and that is what we are going to see in this session. Okay, so there are two kinds of regulatory mechanism in body. First one is the nervous mechanism, that means it is purely neural, okay, neural mechanism, okay, the mechanism which can be produced by means of the central nervous system and different nerve fibers. And second one, it is chemical mechanism, okay, which can be produced. That is, in chemical mechanism, respiration can be controlled by certain chemical constituents of the blood. Okay, first we will deal with the nervous mechanism. But before that, let me give you a basic idea of the respiration. Okay, we have already discussed about all this, but just to refresh your memory. Respiration is having two phases, inspiration and expiration. What are the changes that we can see during inspiration? During inspiration, the respiratory cavity volume increases, the thoracic cavity volume, okay, and the thoracic cage will be expanding, lungs will be expanding, and diaphragm will be contracting. Okay, so usually diaphragm is a dome-shaped muscular membrane. Okay, so in a relaxed state, diaphragm will be looking like this, more convex to upwards. Okay, so what is the structural, what would be the appearance of diaphragm when it is contracted? When it is contracted, diaphragm will be looking more like a flattened membrane. Okay, so contraction makes the diaphragm little flattened like this. So during inspiration, all these changes we can see. Okay, and during expiration, what all happens? All these processes will be happening in the opposite direction. That is, the thoracic cavity volume decreases, the thoracic cage will be constricting, the lungs will be recoiling. Okay, the lungs will be recoiling, and the diaphragm will relax. It attains its normal convex shape. So all these changes we can see during the inspiration. Okay, let me stress one particular point also. That is, for inspiration, it is a purely an active process. Okay, inspiration is an active process which needs the stimulation from some nerves. Okay, it is an active process which needs stimulation. Okay, some impulses have to go to the respiratory muscles to produce inspiration. What about expiration? No impulse. Okay, no stimulation is needed for the expiration. Expiration is totally a passive process. Okay, so the thoracic, we know that the lungs is an elastic organ. Okay, so For recoiling of this elastic organ, there is no external stimulation needed. Okay, when the lungs is recoiling, okay, that is when it is attaining its minimal size and shape and volume, what happens? Naturally, all the structures surrounding it will be constricting, okay, squeezing out the air. So the expiration does not need any impulses. Only the inspiration is produced by contraction of certain respiratory muscles and diaphragm. Okay, for the contraction of respiratory muscles and diaphragm, there is the need of stimulation from the central nervous system. Okay, so from this is a central nervous system, the system which include brain, spinal cord and different afferent and efferent nerve fibers. Okay, so from the central nervous system, the impulses have to go into the respiratory muscles like external intercostal muscles and also to diaphragm. Okay, the nerve fibers which is going into the intercostal muscles is known as intercostal nerves. Okay, and for contraction of this intercostal muscles, the intercostal nerves have to stimulate it. Okay, and second, this is intercostal nerves which is going into the intercostal muscles. You can see intercostal muscles within the ribs. Okay, so when these ribs, external intercostal muscles are contracting, the inspiration will occur. Okay, and second one is the phrenic nerve, which are the nerves going into the diaphragm, okay, which results in the contraction of diaphragm. Okay, so the diaphragm will contract. The intercostal nerves will supply the external intercostal and also internal intercostals. Okay, during inspiration, it will give in external intercostal muscles the stimulation. Okay, so for inspiration, it needs a significant stimulation, and for expiration, the stimulation is not significant. Okay, and for creating the expiration, only the stimulation have to be inhibited. Okay, no certain other mechanism. Only the stimulation to external intercostals and phrenic nerves have to be inhibited. Okay, so no stimulation, no expiration. So this is how the expiration and inspiration will occur. Now we will be dealing with the neural mechanism of regulation. So in the brain, the respiration is controlled by some centers. Neural mechanism. Okay. So, the respiration is controlled by certain centers known as the respiratory centers, which is obviously situated in the brain. More specifically, it is situated in the region of brain stem. Okay, we know the basic regions of brain. This is the cerebral cortex. The expanded portion of brain is known as the cerebral cortex. The cerebrum is in turn divided into certain lobes. Okay, this is the frontal lobe, temporal lobe, parietal lobe and occipital lobe. And we can also see cerebellum. And adjacent to it, we can see an elongated region known as the brain stem. Okay, and the brain stem can be distinguished as two regions known as the medulla and pons. Okay, the upper region of the brain stem is known as the pons. Lower region is known as the medulla. Okay, and the respiratory centers are situated in the medulla and pons. Depending upon the location of this respiratory centers, this can be named as pontine centers and medullary centers. Pontine centers and medullary centers. Those which are located in the pons region is known as pontine centers. those which are located in the medullary region is known as medullary centers. What are centers first of all? Centers are a group of neurons, okay, or a cluster of neurons to which afferent nerve fibers are going, from which efferent nerve fibers are arising. Okay, so in this picture you can see the lower region, that is the medullary region, is having two respiratory centers, okay, which I have figured here as red dots. And in pontine center, more laterally, you can see two respiratory centers in pontine center, okay, in pontine region. So first we will discuss with the medullary center. The medullary center, you can see two centers here, right? Which are the medullary center? First one is the dorsal group of neurons, or dorsal respiratory center, dorsal group of neurons. And ventral respiratory group, alengi, it is a group of neurons, okay, ventral group of neurons. First we will discuss with the dorsal group of neurons or dorsal respiratory group, okay. The dorsal respiratory group is the respiratory center which will produce inspiration, okay. For the inspiration, the stimulation starts from dorsal respiratory group. The dorsal respiratory group is responsible for inspiration. How it will be producing inspiration? It will give impulse, a stimulation to the nerve like intercostals and phrenic nerves. Okay, it will provide the impulses to the external intercostals and the diaphragm. And by the contraction, inspiration will occur. Okay, that too in a rhythmic fashion. Okay, that means this dorsal respiratory group will give a stimulation or impulses for a certain period of time. Okay, after that, the impulse will stop. This will stop. After that, it will again start to fire impulse. After that, it will stop. Okay, like that, in a rhythmic fashion, the impulses are fired. Okay, and during which the impulses are fired, the inspiration occurs. That means inspiration needs impulses. So, when the impulses are supplied, inspiration will occur. Okay, so this time denotes the inspiration. This denotes the inspiration during which the impulses are fired. Okay, after the impulses, some period of these impulses, okay, there comes a phase in which no impulses are fired. Okay, here there is no impulses are fired, during which the expiration will occur. Expiration does not need impulses, so it is only the passive recoiling of the lungs. Okay, so during which the passive recoiling of lungs is occurring and no stimulation, such a phase is known as expiration. Okay, so this phase is known as expiration. After that, again this inspiratory signals, again this inspiratory impulses starts to fire. At that time, inspiration will occur. After that, no stimulation, no impulses. At that time, expiration will occur. Again, inspiration. Like that, the inspiration and expiration occurs in an alternative manner. Okay, and the impulses firing is also alternative. For some period of time, there would be impulses, and the next period of time, no impulse. Then impulse, no impulse, like that. Okay, and the impulse firing is only for 2 seconds. Okay, normally this impulse firing from the dorsal respiratory group into the respiratory muscles is it can vary, okay, but in a normal condition it is of only 2 seconds. Okay, inspiration can happen 2 seconds, that is these impulses can be fired 2 seconds. After, for 3 seconds, there won't be any impulse, there won't be any stimulation, and at that time there is only expiration. Okay, for 3 seconds, expiration. Okay, You can observe by yourself, that is, for inspiration you need, within a limited period of time, you need to complete your inspiration, and after that you are having a relaxed expiration of 3 seconds. Okay, so 2 seconds inspiration and 3 seconds expiration. This is how the dorsal respiratory group of neurons works, and this impulses, this particular impulses it fires, is known as the inspiratory ramp signal. Okay, the rhythmic fashion of firing the impulse. Okay, so this signals is known as inspiratory ramp signals. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now, right now we are talking about medullary center. Okay, the medullary center is divided, is having two respiratory centers. First one, the dorsal respiratory group of neurons that we have just discussed. Next one is the ventral respiratory group neurons. Okay, the medullary respiratory centers divides into dorsal respiratory center and ventral respiratory center. Why it is called dorsal respiratory center? Because it is situated in the dorsal region. Okay, this is a sagittal cut of the brain. Okay, lateral view of the brain. If I am cutting a brain in a half laterally, we can have a figure like this. And the dorsal respiratory group is more situated in the front. Okay, in the dorsal region. And the ventral respiratory group in the back. Okay, so depending upon the position, it is named the dorsal respiratory group. Respiratory group. So this is the frontal view. Okay, this one is the frontal lobe. So this one is the frontal view. So this dorsal respiratory group is situated in the front, and this ventral is situated in the back side. Okay, dorsally and ventrally. So next we are going to see about the ventral respiratory group. Ventral respiratory neurons does not have any role during normal breath. Okay, normal breath is, this one is normal breath, and it is having role in only the forceful breath. Okay, if we are taking some amount of air more forcefully within a limited period of time, it is known as forceful respiration. Okay, we are taking as much of air as we can, and we are giving out that much of amount, okay, maximum amount of air to outside. That is known as forceful respiration. And ventral respiratory group of neurons will facilitate the forceful respiration. Okay, in dorsal respiratory center, we can see only inspiratory neurons. Okay, inspiratory neurons which can fire the ramp signals. It is having only inspiratory, that is, dorsal respiratory group is only responsible for inspiration. So it is having inspiratory neurons which can fire the inspiratory muscles. Okay, inspiratory ramp signals to inspiratory muscles. But what about ventral respiratory neurons? Ventral respiratory neurons will take the whole part of forceful respiration. That means it have expiratory and inspiratory neurons, which will be activated only during forceful breath. Okay, during a forceful respiration, more number of neurons have to be take part, and more impulses have to be fired. Okay, so at that cases, both these inspiratory and expiratory neurons in the ventral respiratory group will take part. Okay, so ventral respiratory center will have both inspiratory and expiratory neurons, and it will be producing forceful breath. Okay, ventral respiratory group will produce forceful breath. Dorsal respiratory center will produce normal inspiration. Okay, and also it can produce expiration, but for expiration there is no need of impulse formation, impulse stimulation. Okay, so for normal breath, this dorsal respiratory center is taking part. So we have now discussed about the medullary region. This is the medullary region. Okay, the dorsal respiratory group of neurons and ventral respiratory group of neurons we have just discussed. Next, we are going to see about the pontine centers. Pontine centers, which are known as the apneustic center and pneumotaxis center. The pontine centers, pontine respiratory centers are, first of all, you can see little lower, in the lower pons, you can see the apneustic center. APNEUSTIC, apneustic center. Okay, in the upper pons, you can see pneumotaxis center. Pneumotaxis, PNEUMOTAXIC. Okay, pneumotaxis center. So first we'll discuss about the apneustic center, okay, which is seen in the lower pons, the apneustic center. The apneustic center will produce inspiration. That means it also produces inspiration, but it can increase the depth of inspiration. So by means of dorsal respiratory group of neurons, it can produce inspiration only for 2 seconds. Okay, normal inspiration. But to increase the depth of this inspiration beyond 2 seconds, if we have to hold the breath to certain period of time, this apneustic center have to take part. Okay, so apneustic center will stimulate, it will give a stimulation to dorsal respiratory group of neurons. Okay, it does not have a direct effect on the respiratory muscles, but it acts through the dorsal respiratory group of neurons. Okay, it is having a direct connection with dorsal respiratory group. So it will have a stimulation on dorsal respiratory group. So the dorsal respiratory group will work more actively. So this inspiration, during normal time it was only 2 seconds, but it can increase the depth of inspiration further. Okay, and that is the function of apneustic center. Okay, and next one is the pneumotaxis center. Pneumotaxis center is having an inhibitory effect. Okay, it also doesn't have a direct effect on the respiratory group. These pontine center will act through only the dorsal respiratory group of neurons. Okay, it does not have a direct effect on the respiratory muscles, but it will affect, it can influence the dorsal respiratory group of neurons. Okay. What does the pneumotaxis center do? It will inhibit the apneustic center. Okay, it does not have any stimulatory effect, but only the inhibitory effect. Okay. So, this red mark denotes the inhibitory signals. Okay, it can send inhibitory signals to the apneustic center. So, the apneustic center cannot work any longer, it is inhibited. So what happens, the dorsal respiratory group of neurons also does not have any enhanced activity. So after a certain period of time, this will be ceased. Okay, no increase in depth of neurons. Okay, so it can produce expiration. Okay, so achieving fast expiration, this pneumotaxis center is working. Okay, so two kinds of respiratory center in the pontine region, which is known as the apneustic center situated in the lower pons and pneumotaxis center situated in the upper pons, the apneustic center will have direct stimulatory effect. Okay, enhance stimulatory effect on the dorsal respiratory group. That is, it can increase the depth of inspiration. Okay, so it can increase the depth of inspiration. So the expiration also will be taking place for 3 seconds. After that, inspiration can again occur with a lengthy duration. Okay. And next one is the pneumotaxis center, which is having inhibitory effect on apneustic center. So it will inhibit the apneustic center. So there is no further stimulatory effect going into the dorsal respiratory group of neurons. So what happens? This increase in depth of neurons, this process of increasing inspiration will cease. Okay, so normal inspiration will be producing. Okay, so these are different kinds of respiratory center which can produce inspiration and expiration. Okay, inspiration needs stimulation, expiration does not need stimulation. It also takes place passively. Okay, and if the inspiration is shortened, okay, inspiration is only of 2 seconds and expiration is of 3 seconds, like that if it is going, we can see the respiratory rate will be very much higher in 1 minute. Okay, that means if the inspiration is accomplished very early and expiration, all these are accomplished very fast. Okay, one inspiration and one expiration produces one respiration. What is respiratory rate? Total number of this respiration in 1 minute is known as respiratory rate. Okay, so by means of this pneumotaxis center, this inspiration is getting shortened. It is not elongated. It is not for an more than 2 seconds of time. Okay, so the pneumotaxis center will restrict the inspiration. So inspiration and expiration will happen in a rhythmic fashion very fastly. So what happens? The respiratory rate can increase. Okay, so the pneumotaxis center is having a role in increasing the respiratory rate. Okay, that means it can increase the total number of respiration in 1 minute. What about apneustic? Apneustic will decrease the rate of respiration. Okay, that means apneustic will produce the inspiration for a certain period of time. Okay, it can produce, this is normal, 2 seconds. Okay, beyond 2 seconds it can produce, and after that there is one expiration. So it can again produce a lengthy inspiration, again expiration, like that. So what happens? Naturally, the number of respiration during 1 minute will be lower. Okay, so pneumotaxis center can increase respiratory rate, apneustic center can decrease respiratory rate. Thank you.